Hi everyone, in this video, you'll learn how to use the WAVE extension to start a manual accessibility audit. Let's get started. WAVE is an extension you can use to test pages for accessibility issues. It is an automated testing tool, but it can be used to help with manual testing. To use WAVE, you'll first need to install it. Check out the links below for the install link and other WAVE resources. Before you start a manual test, you'll need your page sample. This is just the pages you'll test. This should be at least 4 pages. We suggest 4 pages because it's the least amount that's still a representative sample. For example, we suggest picking the home page, 2 prominent pages, and 1 random page. By using at least these 4 pages and addressing all result types, about 80% of issues can be fixed. This is because a lot of the results will be in the website's template or shared components. So fixing them once in the code will fix the issue on every page it's on. For example, if a button has a contrast error and the button is on 30 pages, then fixing it in the code will fix 30 errors. We're going to be using the National Weather Service website. The pages we picked were the home page, weather warnings, wildfire weather safety, and the news page. The news feed adds a different type of content page. We'll start with the weather warnings page. After we finish this page, we would do the same process again on the other pages. To activate WAVE, select the extension icon. The extension shows the results on the left with a summary for each category. The errors and contrast errors are detectable accessibility issues. Alerts are warnings that could be issues but need to be reviewed by a person. The last 3 result types, features, structural elements, and ARIA, help with manual testing. Now we'll start reviewing each result in the Details tab, starting with errors. The first error is language missing or invalid. If you're ever unsure what a result means or what action you need to take to fix or review it, you can select the information icon next to the result in the Details tab, or select the result on the web page and then select Reference. This error just means this page needs a language tag added to it so assistive technology reads the content correctly. And if we look at the other pages, it's an error on them as well. This means if we add one little line of code, we are going to fix the error on every page of this website. Next, we'll document the issue or create a task to fix it. After I'm done reviewing the issue, I can uncheck it in the extension to declutter my view. The next error is an empty button. There are 3 icons, which means there are 3 instances of this error on this page. These icons are also grayed out with a dotted border. This means these results are currently hidden with CSS, but the user could still come across it in a menu or drop-down, for example. To see where the empty button is on the page, turn styles off at the top of the WAVE extension. Now we can select the icon and go to where it is on the page. There are just some dashes, so we actually need to look at the code. So I'll select the icon on the page and then select code. Now I can tell this is an overlay that a user might be able to access. So I need to document this issue for further investigation to find out how the overlay gets triggered and if the buttons are still empty when it is triggered. An interactive component like an overlay is likely to have accessibility issues and should be reviewed with assistive technology. I'll uncheck the empty button and turn the styles back on. The last error is an empty link. I'll select it to go to the result on the page, and it just needs to be removed so a keyboard user can properly navigate the page. The next category is contrast errors. WAVE automatically detected 3 contrast errors. I'll go to the Contrast tab and scroll to the bottom. I can select the result icons here, and it'll populate the foreground and background fields with the color's hex codes. Then I can use the sliders to find a color combination that'll work. There are color issues that WAVE cannot detect, so I'll check the page I'm on for those while I'm here. The first is if there are any gradients or transparent colors, we would need to manually check the contrast for these. The other thing I'll check is if only color is used to communicate information. I can use the Desaturate Page link in the Contrast tab to make the page grayscale. If I go to the home page, only color is used to communicate the types of warnings on the map. So that's a concern I should document and look into more. Now I'll go back to the weather warnings page and the details tab. I'll check off contrast and move on to alerts. I'm going to go through each of these to determine if it is an issue or not. I'll select it to find it on the homepage, turning off styles when needed, use reference and code to investigate it, document it or create a task, and then uncheck it and move on to the next one. Before we move on, I'll review some tips for a few of these alerts. When there is an alternative text result, like the redundant alt text alert, Wave displays the alternative text next to the image in green. You could also look at the code. All images will show as either errors, alerts, or a feature, so by going through each result, you'll check each image for alternative text. I'm going to skip to redundant link to show another example of a result that is hidden on the page. I'll turn styles off and select the icon to go to where it is on the page. I can tell this is in the menu. I'll turn styles back on and hover over the menu to open it, and I can see the alert is actually there, so it would show up to users. The last two alerts I want to touch on are the link to PDF and YouTube videos. These identify places PDFs and YouTube videos are. The PDF and YouTube video would then need a manual check to make sure they are accessible. After all the alerts are reviewed and documented, we can move on to features. These are results that should be helping accessibility. They still need to be checked because it could be implemented incorrectly. The first feature is an image with alternative text. The alternative text for this image is Wireless Emergency Alerts WEA. This image has text in it that says Wireless Emergency Alerts Capable, which doesn't match the alternative text. I'd update the alt text to match the text in the image. So even though it is a feature, it still needs to be fixed, which is why we still manually review features. After I review all the features, I can move on to structural elements. We want to check these to make sure the headings make sense and that structural elements are used properly. On this page, I only have two headings and some lists. The heading 1 and heading 2 both make sense. I'll uncheck those and move on to the lists. Once I finish those, I'll unselect them and move on to ARIA. This website only has 2 instances of ARIA. It is not uncommon to see even 50 to 100 instances of ARIA, though. Every single ARIA result needs to be manually reviewed to make sure it is used correctly, because incorrect ARIA can actually make a website less accessible. The ARIA on this webpage is part of that same overlay we ran into earlier, so we really need to go back and investigate how that overlay works. Next, we would need to use Wave to go through the rest of the pages. Using Wave to go through at least 4 pages is a great start to manual testing, but manual testing also includes keyboard testing, checking zoom levels, and assistive technology testing with a screen reader, for example. Starting with Wave gives us a good feel for the website. It helps simplify manual testing and lets us know areas we should focus on in our keyboard and screen reader testing. You're ready to use the Wave extension to start manually testing your own website.